Did you know Dallas Eakins
was- Honestly, I forgot.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the-
Not nice!
There's a giant head!
You hear yourself?
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Hey, Iggy. Victory puppies, bud! I'm just kidding. Are we friends? We're friends. You okay? You're the victim here. You're the one who feels bad, so he's the victim.
Ew! 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 Leafs win! 7-0!
Here, go ahead. I'll give you time. Space bar, roll it back. No, you heard me say 7-0.
It was 7-0! Over the Anaheim Ducks!
Ooh! Now you see why I was so upset when the Leafs lost to them last time. In a league full of teams actively trying to not be good at hockey, the Ducks are somehow the worst right now. Now for any Ducks fans who are like, stop turning the knife! Number one, I know that feel. Number two, I got my nose broken on Saturday, so does that make you feel better? And number three, it's a little surprise. But real quick first, think you know which way it's gonna go? Make your bet at Sports Interaction. When the puck drops, Sports Interaction has you covered pre-game, live betting on all major sports, and prop bets. Wanna bet? Head to sportsinteraction.com/STPN. That's sportsinteraction.com/STPN. 19 plus, please play responsibly. Now, Ducks fans, here's your surprise. I don't know if it's gonna be enjoyable, but it's certainly gonna be therapeutic. I really should do this segment more. Ducks fans, if I were you. Take it from someone who had to make a video after every single game of the Horacek era Leafs. In the final 55 games of the 2014-15 season for the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Leafs won 11 of them. 11. The Ducks have won once without overtime in the shootout all year. It's almost Christmas. All that to say, Ducks fans, unless you made your living, like you make your living covering the team, you don't have to watch every game, and I'm serious. I think it'll make you like them more. Like, to watch them less, I mean. Like, dude, you saw that game. The Ducks didn't even come out for the third. They were already on the bus to the airport. And the reason I felt compelled to do an If I Were You segment for this video is, don't get me wrong, I was over the moon happy about the Leafs racking up seven in a single game. I'm sorry, turning the knife, you're right. I was really excited about that, but I was watching the Ducks play, and I'm just like, ooh, this looks eerily familiar. It made me feel extra bad for Dallas Eakins and for Sam Carrick because they played for the Leafs version of the Ducks and the Leafs version of the Leafs. Based on my mentions, I don't think Ducks fans are all that fond of Dallas Eakins right now. But the reason I say you don't have to watch every game is you know what's going on. They're trying to lose and they're really good at it. Here's how tight the race is. Once again, they've only won once without overtime in the shootout. They are only 1 point out of second last. Heck, the Coyotes won in overtime over the Flyers. That's a bonus because both teams earn points. Connor Bedard, let's go. But for someone watching a rebuilding team, these are the dog days. The dog days. December? What are you learning in December? They're getting steamrolled. Run over. 7-0 on the road. They have 2 wins on the road all season. Why are you even watching road games other than they're early? January? I don't know what you're doing watching hockey. You live in California. Go enjoy that. To be clear, I'm not saying that people from California don't watch hockey. I'm saying the weather is not awful where you are. You take the good with the bad. I'm looking forward to getting outside and skating, but no, I run the risk of re-breaking my nose. If you need to duck out for a little while, you see what I did? You see? The Ducks will be there when you're ready. There are 52 games left for the Ducks. I think after the All-Star break. After the All-Star break, well, and the All-Star break, because you know they're probably going to try to work in Trevor Zegras there, and he's going to do some fun flippy-dippy stuff, and you could watch that on the highlights. You don't have to watch 2.5 hours of the Ducks getting just murdered 6-1 just to enjoy the one. No, right around the All-Star break, you can jump back in, and you go, all right, who's playing well? Who's worth keeping? Who's developing? Who's doing a good job? And that takes you into the trade deadline. Trade deadline comes, some guys leave, some guys come in, some guys get an opportunity from the AHL team, which has had a pretty decent recent history. And then you can cheer for those performances individually. And that's really when I think you should be looking at the young guys and, all right, are they relishing in the role of spoiler here, because the Ducks can ruin some teams' playoff hopes. If you need to take a month or two off, Ducks fans, do it. You earned it. If you're not willing to do that, that's okay. Dostal might get a dose of games, and he's had good numbers at every level he's played at. He's 22. You don't want to ruin him, but if you are going to watch every game, really look for the young guys. Really look for them and how they perform, because when the Ducks are eventually good again, and they will be good again, it'll feel that much better because of the time you put in. That's what I would do if I were you. Which I think brings us to a worthwhile question, because talking about this game goal by goal doesn't make any sense. From Luke, this is a question for Steve and a question for tonight's puck. Are you in again? How long ago did I say it was over for this group? I don't know, a month? Maybe 5 weeks? Six? Let me tell you. I'm in. At the time I'm shooting this video, I don't know if the Bruins ended up winning their game, but the Leafs are 1 point out of first in the National Hockey League. Heading into the season, we talked about, you know, okay, playoff success, yes, but you can't slay that dragon until the spring. The dragon that you slay over 82 games, if you're a team with aspirations as high as the Leafs, is you can try to win the President's Trophy. And heading into the season, I looked at the roster and I said, it's not wild to think they can do that. The goaltending was a bit of a question mark. It seemed like it was mostly possible. And you know what? For a lot of people's Atlantic Division picks, most people were just a little off. I mean, the big monkey wrench was the Boston Bruins basically going undefeated for the first 2 months. That's wild. And I had the Bruins higher than most people. I didn't have them doing this. And I had the Devils doing better than last year, but I didn't have them doing this either. You know what's unreal about the top three? And you can say I'm a Leafs homer. I've been called worse by better. But out of the top three teams in the NHL right now, Boston, New Jersey, and Toronto, the Leafs are probably the least surprising. The Bruins were very obviously all in, but even if you were really high on them, they started the season without Brad Marchand and Charlie McAvoy for a significant amount of time. And David Krejci was back, but there was no guarantee he was going to be good. It's 2022, you never know. And as for the New Jersey Devils, a step up? Sure, yeah, that's not surprising. 13 straight games? That's 26 points! And then there's the Toronto Maple Leafs, who finished fourth place in the entire NHL last year, and second in their own division because the Panthers won the President's Trophy. Oh, you know what hurt? That. How could you not be in on this team? Who's even playing poorly or mediocre right now? When was the last time you complained about Justin Hall, Alexander Kerfoot had 2 goals tonight! Kerfeet! From Sportsnet's Luke Fox, Alexander Kerfoot has his first 2-goal game since April 2019. What? And first as a Maple Leaf. What? That was his first 2-goal game as a Maple Leaf? He was a Leaf since before COVID! In the before time! In the long, long ago! And that was his first? Bro, Connor Timmins was traded to the Leafs with 7 career NHL points. He headed into this game with 8. He had assists on the first 3 goals! Michael Bunting is on a 9-game point streak. No one cares. Pierre Engvall's decided he has Austin Matthews released somehow. Joey Anderson got his first goal as a Leaf. That dude was traded for Andreas Janssen. That was not recent. Here's how dominant the Leafs were tonight. Sheldon Keefe decided in the third period, you know what? I'm going to take it easy on the Ducks. The goal scorers were Kerfoot, Engvall, and Anderson. Pontus Holmberg had assists on all 3 goals. One thing the Leafs have been praised for a lot this season is their increased willingness to get in front of shots and block shots. They blocked 2 tonight because they were so efficient at just picking the Ducks apart that they didn't have to. The Ducks were out shooting the Leafs something like 5-6-1 in the first period. The Leafs were leading 1-0, and the Leafs ended up out shooting the Ducks 42-28. After 16 shots in the first period, the Ducks had 6 shots in each of the second and the third in a game they were losing the entire time. Like I said, they were on the bus on the way to Pearson. Ilya Samsonov had a 28 save shutout. First of all, I literally, and that word is too overused, but literally cannot remember the last time Samsonov allowed a goal. You know what? I'm gonna check. Let me see if I can guess what game. Who did they play before the Stars? Was it, or no, it was the game after the Stars. Has he allowed a goal since coming back from injury? November 30th. Samsonov has not allowed a goal in December. No, I will not be acknowledging the fact that he's only played 2 games. The last time Ilya Samsonov allowed more than 2 goals in a game was October against the Kings. That was also the last time he lost. He has now won 5 straight. And you don't even gotta mention the top 4. Nylander had 5 points last game, and I was so punch drunk from the friggin' nose break that I forgot to mention it in the LFR. Marner's point streak continued. How far into the video are we? And I haven't mentioned that yet. Tavares scored a pathetic pathetically easy goal. The second I saw that goal go in, I'm like, there's no way they're losing this game. And Austin Matthews really was a cat batting around a ball of yarn all night. That was easy work. All the injuries on the back end to get Brody back, they're even better. And I know people are going to say, okay, take it easy, dude. They beat up on the Ducks. They've been beating up on everyone recently. I don't know if you noticed. And in the games where they weren't beating up on teams, like the Stars, they still found a way to battle and compete and come out with a shutout win. Regression is going to happen. They're going to lose some games they deserve to win. They're going to lose some games they deserve to lose. I mean, in an 82-game season, that's going to happen, obviously. And a lot of you who haven't tuned in since the last Ducks video are like, oh, really, Steve? Dude, this is not the Leafs team that we came into the season with. Not even close. They've shown their ability to dominate offensively, defensively, in net. They've shown an ability to win games they should win, which has been a tough bar to get over at times. They've shown an ability to win games that they shouldn't win. They've shown an ability to win when their lineup is decimated. They've shown an ability to win when they have to sign their fifth goalie. They've shown an ability to win. I'm in. Really? Says Matt Wilkins, showing the standings. The Bruins with 27 games played, 45 points. That's huge. The Devils, 29 games played, 44 points. Huge. And the Leafs tied with them, but one game in hand, 44 points. And let me check my fantasy team. Allmark won. So that means the Bruins are now in first place. Allmark was a waiver pickup for me. You shut your face. You got to do what you got to do.
Oh, Marchessault has 2 goals. Nice.
I watch Leaf games in a way that I found difficult to do earlier this season. I got mad watching them. Not because they lost, but because they looked bad. And sometimes they would look like that and they would still pull it off and they would get awarded, but, and I don't know if this is the right way to put it, they play like a team I want to see rewarded. I think deserves to be rewarded. This team deserves to be where they are, and I'm fired up for them. You could say, Steve, that makes you a Fairweather fan. I don't know why that is. I've been there the entire time. I just called it the way I saw it. And right now, the way I see it's changed. Because it has changed. From It's Mitch Marner, some might look down their nose at a win versus the injured Ducks, but 2 points are nothing to sneeze at. Nice to see the Leafs sniffing the top of the division. They've just got to keep that nose to the grindstone now. Anyway, not to be nosy, but how's your face? Ha ha! Funny joke! I have a broken face. If the only thing of mine that you've seen recently was the last video, you're probably very confused because I had gauze up my nose and it was facing that way. I went to the doctor and I got it reset. It hurt a lot, but he did a really good job, man. Straight, minimal shiner-ness. Is it weird that I sort of wanted a more of a shiner? I feel like I just look like I'm tired, which I am. This isn't a question, but I just wanted to highlight it. Ilya Samsonov with the belt. He got the MVP belt draped over his shoulder in his post-game scrum. Says he's going to sleep with it tonight. Settle down! And lastly, from a Ducks fan, when does the pain end? You know, that's the magical thing about sports, is it goes on and on and on and on. And then one day, it changes. Right now, the Ducks have reasons to hope, or think to hope. Mason McTavish? Okay. Trevor Zegras? He's on the cover of a video game. That could be something. Jamie Drysdale? But if you find a way to get Bedard, Michkov, Fantilli? Oh, this is a great year to stink at hockey. And you know what can make the pain fun? Change. There's probably going to be a lot of change within the Ducks organization in the next few months, so buckle up. It's going to be a wild ride. So, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. 7! I love it.